write down the product in this reaction. Formation of carbocation is RDS of this reaction. RDS is the formation of carbocation. So we always try to get the most stable carbocation. Is there any rearrangement possible that you want?
So over here you can put it on that third degree one and then it becomes.
How do we do that?
The electrons just shift over there.
Okay. Yes, what happened, Rashid? Answer
the question.
Okay.
On the left of the OH.
This one?
Yeah.
OH my OH. OH right? Take it. So the product is that you're getting is this. Right. Only one product. Take it. You see, this H plus.
So it's not two.
Okay, this carbocation. This carbocation is stable. How this carbocation is getting stable? What is the effect there?
Hyperconjugation.
How many alpha ions are there?
Four.
Right? We have one hydrogen here. Okay. Now what happens? We can do the rearrangement here. Rearrangement is possible. Like I said, that whenever carbocation forms, we always try to get a more stable carbocation, right? So what happens, this hydrogen takes this bond pair of electron and shift onto the adjacent carbon which has positive charge, okay? So this bond pair of electron hai, with this hydrogen, it takes these two electron and then this H minus will shift onto this carbon atom, which has the positive charge. And it is only possible with the adjacent carbon hydrogen bond. Yahan pe nahi hoga, okay? Yahan pe possible hai. Else it's possible. So what we get here, you see, we have this. Do we have positive charge here?
Yes.
And this hydrogen comes over here. Now this carbocation is more stable than this because how many alpha hydrogen is here? 3 + 3 + 2. There are 8 alpha hydrogen. So this carbocation is obviously more stable than this, right? So reaction aise hi jayega. We can do whatever we want, but the reaction goes like this. Pehle ye rearrange hoga, we'll get more stable carbocation, and then from this we'll get alkene. Right? So from any one of the carbon atom, we'll take H plus out. Okay? What is the final product we get here?
So, but now where do we know where to put the double? How do we know where to put the double in the final step?
Tell me. Possible product is what?
So you can make double bonds with all three of those carbons.
One product is this.
One is that. Double bond.
The another product is this. Which one is most stable? Yes,
the one on the right.
This one. Because more of the alkene. So major product is this. Product both forms, but this one is more stable.
So why is it more stable?
Because more substituted alkene.
So
The alkene is more substituted.
I don't understand how the double bond is positioned on that side. Like
here.
This side, yeah.
We have a positive charge here. So you can remove H plus from this carbon or from this carbon. This carbon also you can remove, but this one and this one, both position are equivalent position. So whether you remove H plus from this one and this one, you'll get the same product. Okay? So when you remove H plus from this, the bond pair comes over here and we'll get this double. This hydrogen you remove from here. You bond pair hydrogen. Or when you remove this hydrogen, this bond pair comes over here.
So will they show GI? So will they show GI? So the second
one. This one has two CH3s. No, it's not one. Yeah, but there are two hydrogen.
So it's only like beta
two alkyl methyl group
here. Yes.
Sir, can you also
say that carbon? Yes, we can say that. So, but will that logic like match the hypoconjugation logic everywhere?
No. That's why I'm talking about hypoconjugation here.
So
since it is a more dominating effect, right? That's what I'm talking about. Okay, if hyperconjugation is same, then we'll talk about IFP. Okay?
So whenever you have a double bond, it should be substituted as much as possible.
It is always, because this is the more stable product through hyperconjugation.
This would be right both or just the right one?
No, we'll write both, but this one is main, this one is minor. If they ask you what is the product of the reaction, then we always only write the major one. Okay, how many product forms? Two product forms, major and minor. Okay, now you see this one, since this hydrogen is shifted onto this carbon atom, we call it as 1, 2 hydride shift. 1, 2 hydride shift. Similarly, we can have methyl shift and phenyl shift also possible. Right, suppose in this one, if I make one change here, and instead of this carbon, this hydrogen, if you have CH3 present here, then what happens? This methyl will shift over here. And in that case, it's known as 1,2 methyl shift. If you have phenyl group here, then 1,2 phenyl shift. Okay, same thing. Why we do this kind of shifting? To get more stable carbocation. Okay? We always form more stable carbocation. However, here if you write the product from this one, then you have a double bond this side also, minor one, right? But that product is not forming in this reaction at all.
So, but you can only shift one carbon away, right? You can't shift more than one carbon away, right? So, like, let's say my hydride was on that one. Yeah, can I do 1,3 hydride shift?
No, we cannot. Actually, why this kind of shifting happens? Because of this positive charge carbon, the adjacent carbon-hydrogen bond gets polarized. This electron pair is weakly attracted towards the positive charge.
Plus alpha.
Yes. That's why this comes over here and goes from this. But over here, carbon hydrogen bond, there's no attraction. So it won't happen.
So we show major and minor product? Or there's only one
Okay, see, in this reaction,
corresponding that was.
We'll get this first, in the first step, and then this H2O goes out, we'll get a carbocation like this. This is the positive, right?
So it will shift.
What? The carbocation will shift.
Yeah.
So you can
rearrange that one. So we'll get this.
We didn't
do
that.
Yeah, not scam, we have done it. Everything is scam. Any expansion nahi padha hai?
Possible.
Nahi padha nahi hai.
No sir.
No.
Acha.
See what happens actually. This carbocation is 2 degree. And to stabilize this carbocation, maybe one of the bond pair. This one or this one, this will shift first of all onto this carbon atom, and this carbon atom will join with this carbon atom. This we call it as ring expansion. Why this happens? There is a natural tendency of this kind of ring. Smaller ring is not that stable. Okay? The stability order of the ring is this: 3-member, 4-member. And then 5-member ring, then we have 6-member ring, seven-member. This is the order of stability. Okay, the smaller member ring is lesser stable. Why? Because this carbon atom. What is the hybridization here? Hybridization. What is the hybridization here? sp3. So what should be the bond angle? This should be the bond angle approximately, right? But what is the bond angle here? 60. So 109 minus 60, we have 49 degree ka angle strain here. Because of its hybridization, this bond has tendency to expand and get this bond angle. But that is not happening because of this ring. Okay? So we'll have 49 degree of bond angle strain in this ring. Similarly, if it is 90, so 109 minus 90, that is 90. So like this, if you increase the carbon atom in the ring, the angle strain decreases. Angle strain decreases, so stability increases. So all these rings, smaller rings, has natural tendency to convert into larger rings. 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 7 to 6 also. 7 number ring is not just.
No sir, not shifting. Before shifting. After the expansion,
shouldn't it
immediately come on the top
one?
Yeah. No, sir. The one.
We'll discuss that.
Right? Shouldn't the bond strain be minimum in the pentagon?
The angle strain shouldn't be minimum in the pentagon because its angle is 108.
So, 6-member ring, because of its orientation, it's a non-planar, conformational link here. It's a non-planar molecule and it exists in chair form.
Chair.
Yeah.
So
this is the stable chair. No. It's not benzene, cyclohexane. So you just have the chair form. Right? So because of this non-planar structure, this is more most stable structure.
So is heptane also like that?
No, heptane is not stable. Heptane, 6-member ring will convert to that.
So is it non-planar?
This one is non-planar.
Heptane
is also non-planar. It converts into the 6-member.
So, but pentane is planar.
Pentane is planar. It's carbon atom.
So, how do you know when ring
expands? So, this is the order of stability, correct? Yeah, this is the first thing we should know. Right. Now, under what condition ring expansion takes place? Okay. That you should know. Any ring. And if the carbon atom attached to the ring, if this carbon atom has one positive charge into this, then ring expansion is possible. Okay? Means the charge must not be present on the ring. If the charge is present on the ring, then ring contraction will be there. Okay. In this case, ring contraction will be there. Four-member ring, three-member ring will convert. But then again, you say three-member ring will be less stable. So condition of ring expansion is charge must not be present on the ring. It is present on the carbon atom which is attached to the ring. Then ring expansion is possible. If charge is there on the ring, then ring contraction over. So this will convert into this. Right. Here we don't apply this logic that four-member ring is more stable. So why is it converting into three? Because this positive charge is stabilized through dancing resonance. We know this is the most stable carbocation. That's why this conversion is possible. So ring contraction is possible only in two cases, 4 to 3 and then 7 to 6. 7th carbon atom to 6th carbon atom. So this is it. Ring contraction, you let it be. Now here we have, how do we expand the ring? Basically what we do, first of all, we number the carbon atom. We'll start from the positive charge carbon atom. 1, 2, you can number this as 3 or this as 3. Anyone, this is 3, 4 and 5. Starting from the positive charge carbon. We'll number the carbon atom. Now since we have 5 carbon atom present total, so we'll simply we'll close our eyes and we'll draw a 5-member ring. Let's go draw a 5-member ring. Now you number the carbon atom here. Now you see this bond pair comes over here and this 5 attack onto the first one. So it means once 1 is attached with 5. So what we'll write here, this is 1, so this is 5, this is 2, 3 and 4. Correct? Now where we have this methyl group, this is present under the first carbon. So first carbon big methyl group attached. Now here we have one positive charge, so here we should also have one positive charge. Now which carbon atom is losing its electron? 2 or 5? 2 or 5?
So 2.
This is coming over here, so second carbon is losing, right? So second carbon will have one positive charge. This is the carbon. Okay, easy.
That's the product.
No, this is most stable carbon.
So it can also be 3 if the pair goes from 2.
What?
No.
So, but now can that be
1? Do that also. This is clear? Ring expansion? Ring expansion clear? So this is how we do this ring expansion. Now you see, again if this hydrogen comes over here, this secondary carbocation converts into tertiary. The most stable carbocation is this. Eventually you'll get. Okay, most stable carbocation is this. Now from this, if you remove H plus from this carbon or this carbon, the two possible product is this. That also you can do, you'll get the same thing. Anyone? Ye or ye, same stuff. Number change yoga, product will be same. So the answer for this question is this one. This one and this one.
So the second
one is the major. Well, a major over. Is it clear? Yahan pe aaya, theek hai? Yahan se ring expansion hua. 5 member ring is more stable than 4. This one is stable. Now in this case, what is the alpha hydrogen here? Can you tell me? 2 here plus 1. 3. We have 3 alpha hydrogen. How many alpha hydrogen here? 3 plus 2 plus 2. 7. More alpha hydrogen, more stability. So this is the most stable carbocation, right? Now from this, H plus comes out from this carbon or this carbon. These two carbons are equivalent carbon. So either we get a double bond here or here. 2 front ends.
So
on
these two, the one on the right hand side is
more stable.
I told him to teach the cyclohexane,
so I don't know, but I'll take that.
Which one?
maybe he forgot. I'll do
so. What is
alkane, octane, alkene, octane number?
It's just, you know, depends upon the molecules. See, we have this thing, fuel, carbohydrate, petroleum we use. So there we use all this cetane number we have, octane number we have. That actually, you know, gives an idea of the, how efficient the fuel is. Anti-knocking agent we use. We'll do that. These kind of questions, sometimes they are asked in NEET exam. Okay, 2-3 packs we haven't discussed. We'll finish the last one. Anti-knocking agent. Okay, guys, so this, you understood this one. Okay, so we'll. This is a little complex. Okay. See, why? Wait. See, can we do this? After this, we got this carbocation, right? These two are same thing. We got this, and then this converts into this. By 1-2 hydride shift. This step is 1-2 hydride shift. Okay, to write down the this ring, to draw this ring, we'll number the carbon atom and then we'll attach. Okay, so this is the same. Okay, now you tell me why not? Here we have 1-2 hydride shift. Okay, so we have that carbocation. You see, the carbocation is this. Can we do 1-2 hydride shift here, not this ring expansion? So if you shift this hydrogen here, again you will get 3-degree carbocation, yes or no? You get 3-degree carbocation. Okay. So why this is not happening?
So ring is more stable.
This is stable. But this one is also 2-degree, it's converting into 3-degree.
So because after that you'll have to contract.
How many alpha hydrogen we have here? 3+1, 4.
Yes.
How many alpha hydrogen we have
here? So same.
2+2, 4 alpha
hydrogen. No, so but it has more. It's plus charge and it has.
So it has 6.
It has 6.
Oh
yeah.
So 2+2+2.
Yeah, it has.
3 and 4.
6.
Yeah, 6.
So, this is more alpha hydrogen, less number of alpha hydrogen. So this one is more stable than this. But again, if you compare this carbocation and this carbocation, it is present on the larger member ring. So angular strain is less here. So, this one is more stable than this. Because angular strain is dominating.
Does it have any angular strain?
Well, ring may have. They have angular strain
on
the other
carbon.
So, here we have less angular strain.
So, also,
where does it contract?
Yes,
sir. So, why doesn't it
contract? Okay. Because this carbocation is not more stable than this. So, you form any.
No, but if it was formed.
No, it form hoga hi nahi. But you can form kar sakte ho. Molecule won't form. See. You can draw this. Again, you are getting it. Because after this, you'll get dancing resonance and all. No, that's why you are getting emotional. Don't get emotional. So, we always go towards the more stable carbocation, right? So, this carbocation is more stable than this. This ke baad jo hoga, ye nahi hoga. See, in this also, if this hydrogen shift over here, then we'll get a carbocation here, right? In that case, alpha hydrogen is what? Only 2, which is less stable. That's why that shifting is not possible. So whenever a rearrangement is there, we always go towards the more stable carbocation. Okay? In the next step also, if you're getting most stable carbocation, then also, this is not possible.